That is an autocross, where you just take a quick and nimble car and you put it through the pilings. Hi, I'm Mark Fulmer. This is the 2009 Mitsubishi Lancer Ralliart. Now, it's the middle child in this Lancer family, the EVO being the big older brother. But let's take a ride in this, the Ralliart, and who better to tell us about it than its product strategy manager, Bryan Arnett. Now, the name Ralliart has rally in the front part of it, and I think that's for a purpose. How does rally relate to the Lancer?
Well, the Ralliart name first got its start with our motorsports division, and Ralliart itself was spawned out of a result of the Evolution's participation in WRC and the need for a motorsports organization within Mitsubishi. And the Ralliart was the name of that organization. And today we continue that theme of motorsports with our high-performance vehicles named Ralliart.
And you've done rather well, I would say, in that sport, wouldn't you?
Sir, yes. We've got four consecutive World Rally Championships under our belts at the Lancer Evolution, and just getting ready to actually participate in the Paris-Dakar with a new vehicle called the Racing Lancer, which is built off of our Lancer 5-door, which just recently launched in Europe.
So how does that translate to me, the average driver? How does that feel when I get out on the freeway like now, and when I need to pass a car, or when I need to make some moves?
Well, a lot of the engineering that is done on our motorsports activities, those same engineers also work on our passenger car lineup. So a lot of the experiences that we have with our motorsports, mainly durability issues, a lot of that engineering and that experience that we do in our motorsports finds its way into our passenger cars as well. And what that basically means to the average Joe is a much more durable vehicle as a result of a lot of the motorsports participation that we do. And this is a great example of how the culmination of our motorsports experience finds its way into an everyday vehicle like this one.
Okay, so let's break it down in terms of some of the elements of the performance. Let's start with steering. How would you describe the steering feel of the Ralliart?
Well, the Ralliart steering is obviously a lot sportier than a conventional standard Lancer Ralliart. We start with a smaller diameter sport steering wheel. In fact, this is the same steering wheel that's carried over from the Lancer Evolution series. And then we've made some adjustments to the variable flow pumps within this rack and pinion setup, basically to create a little bit more feedback to get the driver a little more reaction when driving, for a little more fun to drive. We've also made available magnesium alloy paddle shifters right on the steering column so that the driver can engage with the transmission.
One of the features of the Ralliart that is truly impressive is the dual clutch system.
Yes.
Translate that for us.
Well, this vehicle is equipped with what we call a TCSST, or a twin clutch sequential sportronic transmission. Essentially what this transmission is a semi-automatic manual transmission. What that basically does is means that it operates in the same way as a manual transmission, except there's an electronic control unit that does a lot of the shifting schedules for you. You have the ability to put this transmission in D and operate in automatic mode, or with the flick of the paddle switch you can go to manumatic mode and operate the transmission using a twin clutch setup.
So does a dual clutch system make me shift quicker or smoother or both?
The dual clutch system basically will allow the transmission to shift much, much quicker than a single clutch. The way the dual clutch system works essentially is that there's two clutches within the transmission casing. One clutch is set up on the odd gears, and another clutch is set up on the even gears. So while you're engaged in first gear, the second clutch is already set and ready to go for the second gear. And this enables the transmission to react much, much quicker, within milliseconds of the command.
There must be a computer involved here.
Yeah, there's a lot of computers involved. Yeah, there's a transmission control unit, and then there's also an engine control unit. And these two computers are speaking to each other all the time while you're driving. So the transmission will know the engine load, the throttle position, and basically tell the transmission when to shift and where to shift.
Now, if the computers, let's say, freeze up, you still have a backup manual mode, right? You're not hung up there.
Well, yeah, if you want to completely ignore the computers, you can drop the gear shift lever into manumatic, And basically, then you're the computer, and you have full manual control over the transmission. Unlike a lot of other transmissions, this transmission will hold all the way to red line and continue to hold at red line. It will behave exactly like a manual transmission.
Now, the Lancer series has always been very, very reliable. Does a dual clutch mean twice the possibility of mechanical maintenance or upkeep or anything like that?
No. In fact, the transmission itself is actually simpler than a conventional manual transmission. There's actually fewer moving parts. There's no torque converter. So with its simplicity comes actually more durability.
Now, you had mentioned to me that if I own the Ralliart, it's going to recognize me when I put my hands on the door.
Right.
What do you mean by that?
Well, all the Ralliarts are equipped with a passive entry system we call FastKey. The FastKey system basically is a transmitter that allows you to approach the vehicle. There are biometric sensors on the inside of the door handle, and when you reach for the door handle, the sensors will automatically communicate with the transmitter and unlock the door, and then allow you to start the engine without ever taking the key in and out of your pocket.
Can I install this in my house? You know, for teenage boys and stuff like that, you know, to kind of keep them out. That sounds terrific. Okay, but here's my problem, Bryan. I've got 2,000 songs that I love to listen to. Is that going to be a problem on the Ralliart?
Well, no. Actually, if you equip the Ralliart with our hard disk drive navigation system, we have a 40-gigabyte hard disk drive system that will actually store all of your 2,000 songs right on the hard drive. Very easy to get to, all with a touch of a button.
It seems like Mitsubishi has always been really concerned with staying on the edge of new technologies. What are some of the new technologies coming up that we might look forward to in, let's say, 2010?
Well, obviously Mitsubishi has a long history of turbocharged technologies, so you can look for more exciting turbocharged technologies from Mitsubishi. You can look for also technologies involving electric powertrains in the future. Recently, we've recently announced that beginning in 2009, we will launch the electric iCar in Japan market, and that is a all-new alternative powertrain technology that promises some exciting things for Mitsubishi in the future.
In the Ralliart's all-wheel capability, there are three modes. Explain those three for me.
Yeah, with the all-wheel drive system in the Ralliart, essentially we've taken the same powertrain that was used on the previous generation Lancer Evolution 9. It's equipped with what we call an active center differential. This differential has three different modes, tarmac, gravel, and snow. And essentially what these different modes are, they're different program algorithms that are proprietary with Mitsubishi. And they will allow the driver to select what is the road condition that they want the all-wheel drive to operate on. Obviously, for tarmac, you would put it in this mode for dry pavement conditions, snow for slippery or wet conditions, and gravel for loose sand or dirt. So it gives the driver lots of options for varying road conditions to optimize the performance of the all-wheel drive system itself.
So with that kind of capability, what type of tires do you put on the Ralliart?
Well, this car here is equipped with a summer-rated Yokohama A10 performance tire. We also make available through our parts and service department an all-season tire for this vehicle as well. So the rubber on this tire is designed for more performance-oriented driving.
Well, and speaking of performance driving, how long am I going to own the Ralliart before I'm going to be salivating for an EVO?
Well, as long as you'd like. the Ralliart is designed as a vehicle for people who are looking for maybe a little more convenience than an Evolution. So we don't think that the Ralliart is going to be the replacement for an Evolution buyer. The person who aspires to the Evolution and really wants one certainly will go out and get one. This is, however, a great step in between the Lancer and the Evolution series. Provides all the power and performance that you'd want with a lot of the conveniences that you need on an everyday today, drive.
Okay, Bryan, tell me a little bit about eTech and how I can customize the vehicle for my own personal preferences.
Sure. This vehicle is equipped with an eTech system, which is an electronic alarm timing control system. Basically, what this system operates with is a CAN bus, or a central area network. And when equipped with a navigation system, you can plug that navigation system in and find various settings to go ahead and program all the electronics in the vehicle to your personal preference. The speed of the windshield wipers, the answer back alarm system, the power door lock function, all of these, all of the electronics in this vehicle can be customized through the e-tax function customizer that's built into all of our navigation systems.
Mitsubishi has always been about engineering, and do you think that that will continue on into the future as the Lancer family continues to evolve?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Mitsubishi, at the heart of the company, has always been an engineering-driven company. We'll continue to aspire to push the boundaries of engineering and push the boundaries of performance as the company continues to grow and expand here in the United States.